今日主要想同大家讲一啲关于 DSE Econ 入边 elasticity 嘅题目嘅。咁喺 long prep 方面，就会教大家一个公式化嘅作答步骤，等你全中 marking scheme 入边嘅分数啦。而喺 MC 方面，就会教你一个谂嘢嘅 flow 啦，等你做 MC 嘅时候会做得快啲啦，同埋减少自己出错嘅机会。
咁首先咧，就想同大家睇咗 long prep 先嘅。咁我就將 demand and supply 入面嘅 long prep 咧，就分咗咁多類嘅 question types 啦。咁每一種嘅 question type 咧，都有佢自己公式化嘅作答步驟，就可以全中到個 marking scheme 嘅。今日同大家講嘅係一直都成日出嘅 question type， 就係 explain under what condition would the total revenue increase or decrease。咁我哋可以睇一條practice paper 嘅題目先啦。咁就係、The earthquake in Japan greatly damaged the production facilities of memory products like SD cards. As a result, the prices of these products rose. With the aid of a diagram, explain under what condition the total expenditure of Japanese consumers on the memory products would fall. 咁我哋一見到 explain under what condition 咧，其實我哋已經要知道佢係想我哋答關於 elasticity 方面嘅嘢啦。咁我哋答呢種題目嘅時候就五步曲啦。有時候你自己做past paper， 你會發現答唔足依五步曲都有機會係攞足足曬 marking 入邊嘅分啦。咁但係你唔知道你嗰年嘅 marking 係點樣出嘅，咁所以你做齊依五步曲咧，就可以避免自己失任何嘅分數啦。咁其實答任何 demand and supply 嘅題目嘅時候咧，正常都係你答咗文字個 part 咧，先去畫嗰個圖咧係會快啲嘅，因為你已經知曬嗰個 scenario 係發生咩事，你先去畫嗰幅圖咧，其實係會快好多嘅。所以我就會由verbal elaboration 嗰度開始講啦。咁用翻依條題目做 illustration 啦，我哋第一步要答嘅就係究竟係個 demand 或者 supply 係升定係跌。咁我哋知道係 damage the production 啦，咁所以嗰個 memory products 嗰個 supply 咧就係會跌嘅，所以我哋第一步就寫翻啦 ，supply decreases。咁第二步咧，無論題目本身有冇俾到你嗰個 price 嗰個 effect 都好啦，我哋都係要寫翻個 effect on P and Q 嘅。咁我哋就可以話啦 ，price increases and quantity decreases 啦，就係 supply decreases 個 effect 啦。跟住去到第三步，我哋就要寫到底係個 demand 或者 supply 係 elastic 或者 inelastic 嘅。依度想提翻大家一個位啦，如果佢係一個 shift in supply curve 嘅話咧，我哋要答嘅唔係 elasticity of supply 咯，即係你唔係要話 supply is elastic or inelastic， 而係你要答 elasticity of demand 咯。因為當你喺嗰個 supply curve shift 嘅時候，其實你係一個 movement along the demand curve 咯，咁所以你係要答 elasticity of demand， 而唔係 elasticity of supply 嘅。咁相反咧，如果佢係一個 shift in demand curve 嘅話咧，你要答嘅嘢就係 elasticity of supply 啦，因為佢係一個 movement along the supply curve 嘅。咁呢個位咧係都幾多人會搞亂嘅。咁翻嚟條題目啦，我哋題目俾咗我哋個結果就係話要個 total expenditure 係 fall 嘅。咁我哋就知道啦，當 supply 跌嘅時候 ，P 升同埋 Q 跌。我哋最後要令到嗰個 overall 咧係 decrease 嘅話，即係 percentage decrease in quantity 係要大過percentage increase in price 嘅。咁當我哋嗰個 Q 個轉變係大過 P 嘅時候咧，我哋就會知道啦，我哋嗰個 demand 咧就係 elastic 嘅，即係凡係你嗰、那個percentage change in quantity 係大過 percentage change in price 嘅話，你就會知道啦。即係嗰啲quantity demanded 咧係好sensitive to price 嘅，咁所以就係 elastic demand 啦。咁我哋就 state 翻啦 ，condition 就係 elastic demand 啦。跟住咧第四步我哋就要話啦 ，percentage decrease in quantity is greater than the percentage increase in price。咁大家用個字眼咧就要小心啲啦。可以用 percentage change in quantity 或者 percentage change in price 嘅，而系要写翻明究竟系 decrease 定系 increase 嘅。我哋最后嗰步就写翻啦 ，total expenditure increases or decreases 啦。咁呢个系题目已经俾咗你，你就 restate 翻，令到你嗰个答题系更加之清晰嘅。咁嗰个 examiner 个印象咧会好啲嘅。咁之后咧就去到画图嘅部分啦。咁咧其实好多时候咧，你去画图嘅话咧， 你跟 textbook 就會知道依一 part 係 elastic 啦，咁你可能就要度位，就嗰個 midpoint 喺邊度啦，跟住之後你又要就住咁樣畫，仲要嗰個變化可能唔係好明顯。咁其實咧，當你畫 elastic demand 嘅時候咧，你將嗰條線咧係畫得平啲嘅話，就好容易咧畫到嗰個 change in quantity 係大過 change in price 嘅。咁相反啦，如果你係畫一個 inelastic demand 嘅話咧，你將條線畫得 vertical 啲咧，就好容易畫到咧係個 price 嘅 change 咧係會大過 quantity 嗰個 change 嘅。咁大家咧畫圖嘅時候咧，記住啦，要標翻嗰個 gain 同埋 loss 啦，因為睇翻個 marking 咧，其實係直成兩分嘅，你 indicate in the diagram 嘅話。咁我哋可以睇翻咧 verbal elaboration 嗰度個 marking 啦，其實都係會涵蓋到我啱啱講五部曲入邊嘅嘢咯。Supply decreases 啦 ，condition 講翻係啲咩啦 ？Percentage decrease 同埋 percentage increase 邊個係大啲咁樣嘅？係啦，我哋可以睇多條題目咧去做 illustration 嘅，咁就係2013年嘅題目啦。咁佢今次就係話 ，With the aid of a diagram, explain under what condition the total expenditure of passengers on the MTR would increase because of the rise in fare. Rise in fare 咧，即係 price increases 啦。咁條題目本身已經幫我哋由第二步開始做啦，咁所以今次我哋就唔使做第一步啦。咁根據 law of demand 啦，當 price increase 嘅時候，咁即係 quantity 係 decrease 啦。咁所以我哋頭兩步咧，好簡單咁樣去做翻啦。Price increases, quantity decreases. 跟住之後就要 state 翻嗰個 condition 啦。咁今次我哋諗啦，題目俾我哋嗰個後結果咧，就係話要係 increase 啊嘛 ，total expenditure。咁我哋 overall 要 increase 嘅話，即係 percentage increase in price 咧，係要大過 percentage decrease in quantity 嘅。咁喺呢個情況下，當我哋嗰個 change in price 係大過 change in quantity 嘅話咧，我哋就知道係一個 inelastic demand 啦。咁我哋就 state 翻個 condition 啦，就係 inelastic demand 啦。咁跟住之後咧，我哋就要寫翻嗰一句啦。Percentage increase in price is greater than the percentage decrease in quantity. 咁記住唔好就咁寫 change， 而係要寫埋到等佢係升定係跌嘅。咁最後嗰個結果做翻一個 small conclusion， 就係 total expenditure increases 啦。咁畫翻個圖啦，啱啱都講過啦 ，inelastic 畫得條線係 vertical 啲，咁就已經 OK。唔好唔記得要標翻嗰個 gain 同埋 loss， 因為都係值兩分嘅。咁佢依度係今次啦，係啦，都係值兩分啦。咁你一定要 show 到嗰個 gain 咧，好明顯咧係要大過個 loss 噶。咁如果大家咧要保險起見嘅話咧，驚畫得唔夠明顯咧，你可以喺依度加翻喺隔離嗰度啦，咁就更加清楚，咁更加 secure 到依一分咯。咁其實有時候咧，你會見到咧。個 marking 咧，你做某啲年份啦，譬如依啲佢會話 percentage change 啦，依度又係 percentage change 啦 ，percentage change 啦，但係佢有時又會變咗係 percentage increase 啦 ，percentage decrease 嘅喎，依度又係 percentage change 啦。咁其實你唔知嗰個 marking 究竟幾時係要你寫 percentage increase or decrease 啦，但係有時淨係你好 general 咁樣話 percentage change 就已經 OK 咯。咁所以咧，大家。保險起見，跟翻依五步曲去答咧，就唔使驚失分啦。咁跟住咧，我哋就會睇下 MC 嘅題目啦。咁其實 MC 我係分咗做好多隻嘅題型啦。咁每一隻題型咧都有佢諗嘢嘅 flow 咧。咁就等大家做 MC 嘅時候係做得快啲啦，有系統啲，同埋減少出錯嘅機會。今日同大家講咧就係其中一種 elasticity 嘅題型。咁佢就係已經講咗喺 price 同埋 quantity 嘅 effect 係啲咩。咁就問翻你 demand 或者 supply 係 elastic 或者 inelastic 嘅。咁呢类题目咧，我哋可以睇下啲题目做 example 啦。咁佢可能话 ，The price of umbrella increased by 10%， while the quantity transacted increased by 15%。What is the price elasticity of demand or supply of umbrellas in the above situation？ 咁咧，首先我哋第一步要 identify， 好似啱啱 long quote 都讲过啦，究竟佢系一个 movement along the demand curve 定系 supply curve？ 今次题目已经话咗俾你知。price 係升嘅 ，quantity 係升嘅，所以我哋知道 demand 今次咧嗰個轉變就係 demand increases 啦。當 demand 係 increase 嘅時候咧，我哋記住要答嘅嘢並唔係 elasticity of demand， 而係 elasticity of supply， 因為佢係 movement along the supply curve 啊嘛。 咁所以我哋好簡單啦，已經可以刪除咗 A 同埋 B 啦，因為我哋要揾嘅係 supply 啊。咁佢題目已經講咗嗰個 quantity percentage increase in quantity 係 15%， 咁就大過嗰個 percentage increase in price 咧，即係 10% 噶。啱啱講 long quote 都已經講過啦，凡係當嗰個 percentage change in quantity 大過 percentage change in price 嘅話，即係意味住嗰個 quantity demanded 咧係好 sensitive to 個 price 嘅，咁所以咧就係 elastic 啦。所以我哋可以睇到啦 ，supply is elastic， 答案係 C 啦。咁我哋可以再睇多條題目啦。咁2006年嘅題目就話係 fearing an outbreak of bird flu 啦，跟住之後 people tend to buy more canned food 嘅。咁由於佢係一個唔係 due to price changes， 但係又買多咗啦，所以我哋知道係一個 increase in demand 啦。increase in demand 即係 price increase， quantity increases 啦。跟住我哋咧。今次由於是一個 shift in demand curve 啦，所以好似啱啱上邊嗰題咁樣樣，我哋知道我哋要揾嘅係 elasticity of supply， 好簡單，又係可以刪除咗 A 同埋 B 嘅答案啦。跟住今次我哋睇到呢個要自己計一計數啦，因為佢就係俾咗個數字你。咁我哋知道係35% 啦，咁個 percentage increase in quantity 35% 係細過個 percentage increase in price 即係50% 嘅。咁今次啱啱我哋上面嗰個 Q 大個 P 就係 elastic 啦，今次 Q 細個 P 咧，咁我哋就知道係 inelastic， 所以個答案咧就係 D 啦。咁我哋可以再睇多條題目啦，咁就係 practice paper 嘅題目啦。我哋而家就係話有個 political unrest 啦，所以就 30% increase in the price of gasoline and a 15% change in the quantity transacted of gasoline 嘅。咁跟住我哋就知道啦 ，political unrest 令到嗰個 gasoline 咧個 supply 咧就係少咗，所以今次我哋就係 supply decreases 啦。我哋今次由於係 shift of supply curve 啦，所以要答嘅嘢就係 elasticity of demand 啦。所以我哋今次就可以好容易 delete 咗 C 同埋 D 啦。跟住今次佢話俾我哋知咧，個 quantity 嗰個 change 咧，其實就係15% 啦，而 price 咧就係30% 嘅。咁個 percentage change in price 咧係大過個 percentage change in quantity 啦，咁所以咧我哋就知道咧今次就係 inelastic 啦。咁其實 MC 咧基本上咧個 skill 咧都係咁樣做啦，最緊要咧就係 identify 咗究竟佢係 movement along the demand or supply curve， 咁你好簡好容易咧就已經會 eliminate 到兩個答案噶啦。
咁今日嘅分享咧就差唔多嚟到呢度啦，咁大家可以 like 呢个 video 啦 ，subscribe 我个 channel 啦，同埋 like 翻我个 Facebook page 嘅。咁另外咧，我就有卖自己 DSE 各科嘅笔记啦。咁如果大家咧想睇翻一个免费嘅 sample 嘅话咧，都可以 click 翻咧 info box 嗰条 link 嘅。咁多谢大家睇呢段片啦，咁下次有机会嘅话，再同大家分享读书嘅心得啦，拜拜。